Hello dear chess lovers. Today I am going to show you a new game between Edgar Cole and Jules Delvaux in Belgium 1929. Cole was famous Belgian master, died only 34 years old. He was born in Belgium. He won Belgium championship for 4 times. His international successes were Scheveningen, Amsterdam and Meran tournaments. As first prized, Echt of Tartakower, Öwe, Spielmann and Yates. He died only 34 years old because of gastric ulcer. He was famous for the most known opening, Cole system. In this game, he played Cole system against his opponent with white pieces. Cole is white. D4 played by Cole. Knight f6 black played. It's Indian game. Knight controlling the light squares on the center. Now knight f3. Cole played knight f3 and e6. With playing this move, Black's intention is developing his dark square bishop. Now Cole played e3. Now Cole's c1 bishop is looking at pawn chain. So this is a bad bishop for white. And also Black's c8 bishop is bad bishop because of the pawn formation of Black's. Now Black played d5 in the game. After this move, this opening is called Cole system. Normally, Cole system arises from d4, d5, knight f3, knight f6, e3, e6. But in this game, the move order is different. But now, this opening transposes to Cole system. Now, white played bishop d3. This bishop is looking at h7 pawn, and if black will play castling short, maybe white's plan is bishop takes h7 Greek sacrifice gift, after this knight h5 and queen h5 and knight g5. But for making these trades, white has to kick this f6 knight from the defense by moving his pawn, pushing his pawn to e5 square. And now black played c5 in the game, attacking center with his flank pawn, c5, attacking d4 pawn. Now black has a trade to play c4 and retreating, kicking the bishop. Because of this, white had to play c3 in the game. And making a space for his bishop. If black plays c4, bishop escaping to c2 square. And now black played knight c6, developing knight, and white played knight b to d2. And bishop e7 black and white castling short. Now black finally played c4, attacking white's bishop, and bishop goes to c2 square. Instead of c4, if black played b6 in the game and continue the tension in the center, now white may play knight e5 and knight takes e5, d takes e5 and kicking the knight from f6, and knight goes to d7. Now attacking the central pawn with his knight so that white may play f4 for defending his pawn. Now because of black hasn't castling short yet, Greek sacrifice gift attack is not so dangerous for blacks. So it's a almost equal game. But in the game, after c4, bishop goes to c2 and black played b5. Black is playing on queen side and white wants to play on the center. If your opponent is attacking on flanks, queen side or king side, you can play from the center. It's a good strategy for players. E4. Now the trade is E5, kicking the knight to F6 square. D takes E5, knight takes E5, and castling short. Now queen goes to E2. White has a plan. If black takes knight, white wants to take with queen and makes a threat, mate threat with queen, bishop better. Now black is playing bishop b7, developing his bishop. Now white played knight f g5. White's threat is knight takes knight check. If bishop takes knight, after knight takes h7, winning a pawn. So that black played h6 for kicking the knight on g5 square. But it is not a good move. It's a bad move. Instead of this, black had to play it. Knight takes e4 and queen takes e4. Mating threat from h7 square with queen and bishop battery and also queen and knight. So black had to play g6. Now queen h4, making trade again from h7 square with queen and knight. Now black has to take capturing knight. Bishop takes g5. Bishop takes g5, attacking black's queen. Now f6, interposing. Bishop h6, attacking black's rook. Now rook goes to f7, defending h7 pawn. Now bishop goes to e4. If now black played f5, white bishop can go to f3 square. But instead of this, if black played queen d7, now black queen is defending both his bishop, rook, and also h7 pawn. There is no problem for blacks if black played this variation. But in the game, after h6, black white played knight takes f6 check. And now g takes f6 is not good because of the pawn formation. Black played bishop takes f6. And after this, queen e4. Now mating threat from h7 square with queen bishop battery and also queen and knight. So black has no time for taking this knight. G6 is forcing move. Now white made a sacrifice. Knight takes e5. In the game, black played f takes e5 and accepting this sacrifice. Instead of this, if black played knight takes d4, a discovered attack to white queen, white's queen. White played queen takes d4. Now both queens are hanging on the board. Look at this. Both queens are hanging and black played queen e7. White plays maybe play queen to e3, queen takes e6, queen takes e6, exchanging queens, f takes e6, bishop takes h6, attacking rook, bishop g7, interposing bishop g7, knight, king takes g7, and this position is better for white because white has one more pawn at, and also look at the pawn structure. White has two pawn islands, but black has three, and black's two of the pawns are isolated, e6 and g6. They are weak pawns, so that white position is better. But in the game, after accepting the sacrifice by black, white's position is now winning. Queen takes g6, check. Bishop g7, forcing move. Queen h6, check. King f7, forcing move. Bishop g6, check. For not giving his bishop to white, black king has to go knight, king f6 for defending his bishop. And now black white played bishop h5. Clearance. Clearing the square for his queen. Now after queen check, black king has to go e7 and black and white will capture this bishop. So preventing this, for preventing this, black played knight e7 and controlling g6 square. Now white played in the game bishop takes h6, 20th move, and c1 bishop finally entering the game with a great threat, attacking black's bishop. But now white's bishop is a poisoned bishop. If black takes this bishop, white played queen takes h6 check, knight g6 interposing is forcing move, queen takes g6 checking again, king go to e7, queen g7 check, if rook interposes, rook is free for white's pieces, so that black king has to go d6 square, and now the move was a skewer, so that black white queen takes b7, black's bishop, and white's position is good because he has one bishop ahead and also three pawns ahead, so that black's position collapse after this variation. But in the game, after bishop takes h6, black played rook g6, defending his bishop. And now white played h4, a mating threat from bishop g5. So preventing this mate threat, black played bishop takes h6. And after that, white played queen f7, checkmate, and Cole won this game only in 22 moves. Instead of bishop takes h6, black can play e5, but now white takes bishop takes g7, check, rook takes g7. Now black king defending his rook, and white plays d takes e5. Deflection. Deflecting the black king to the defense of his rook, and black king has to go somewhere or has to take this pawn. For example, king e6, queen takes g7, and white's position is better. White has the exchange and also has more 4 pawns ahead. But in the game, after bishop takes h6, Cole played queen f7 mate. A great brilliant game from Cole, Belgian supermaster, died only 34 years old in his own system. If you like this game, like and share this video, and if you more like, please subscribe to my channel. See you on later videos. Goodbye.